crucial cause it's very sublime. I'm so excited cause it really is time for 9 at 9. 9, 9, 9, 9, 9. Woo! So tell us what's new, now let me throw you a cue. It's 9 at 9.
Well, last week we did an interview with the director of a new docuseries about Baywatch. The director was a nice guy named Matthew Felker. He's from Wisconsin, but he lives in Malibu. And some people were thinking that he looks kind of familiar, and they're right. He was in Britney Spears' music video for Toxic.
Wow.
Felker moved to Hollywood to be a model, and he doesn't mind if people recognize him as the guy from the video. He said the Britney Spears thing is flattering. If someone remembers it or knows about it, that's great.
I thought you were going to say he looks like that guy from Revenge of the Nerds, the big football player
guy.
Oh,
yeah,
yeah.
Ogre. Yeah.
Yeah.
Ogre. Yeah.
Right?
He does look like him.
That's a deep dive.
That guy's big, though, yeah.
Oh. Hmm. Anyway,
he
I'll find
some
it.
Look, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
A lot going on.
Yeah.
Number eight, we love, you're darn right we do. We love pandas around here.
Yeah, we do.
So let's look at the lifespan of a panda. I mean, I could have done this story for you without even reading the script, but scientists aren't sure how long giant pandas live in the wild, but they do know it's shorter than lifespans in zoos. A giant panda will live about 15 to 20 years in the wild. But when under human care, it jumps to around 30 years.
Woo, good for us.
Researchers in China, what do they got, Hannibal Lecter in that thing or a panda bear? My God. In China, some zoos have reported that pandas live until 35.
Wow.
Mm. What a blessing.
Yeah. Time's ticking for all of us.
You might be on the panda bears, but now I'm on the chimps. Have you been watching Chimp Crazy on HBO Max?
I'm going to tell you what you need to watch. We had this conversation. You watched that Chimp Empire on Netflix?
Now, what's that one?
Your whole view of the chimpanzees is going to change.
Really?
They got embedded with the chimpanzees. I think it's in the, is it in the Congo? I don't know.
LaGrange.
They are vicious. They're murderers, those chimpanzees.
Well, this Chimp Crazy on HBO Max talks about the people who have them as pets.
This is, that way. Ooh. Here's what happens.
Oh, boy. That's
they put one or two chimpanzees on a tricycle, and everybody thinks
good.
They're nice animals. Uh-huh. They're not.
No.
They're murderers, these chimpanzees.
No. It's crazy.
Don't you be fooled for a second.
We're going to have to do a whole segment on chimps.
We have a whole segment. Pat and Robin's Animal Corner.
Very Rainer.
I see it now.
Two non-experts talk about the animal kingdom.
Let me tell you, those chimps.
Great idea.
Great idea.
I got to tell you all about them.
Oh, right. Fantastic. All right.
Chimps.
Number seven.
Yeah, time. Sold a bill of goods on them. Let me tell you.
Time to check out your jewelry boxes, or how about your grandma's jewelry box? Brooches are back.
Mm-hmm.
Some people say brooch. My grandma always said brooch. The head of The Real Real, which is a high-end fashion resale outlet, says they are seeing more and more people showing interest in vintage brooches. They're pairing them with scarves or pinning them to hats, using them on blazers. Anyway, it's for a pop of whimsy. Go ahead, bling out your denim, do whatever you want. It's a thing right now. Yeah.
Big brooches. Okey-doke, all right, number six. What time is it on the moon? Good question, and some lunar scientists are trying to help us figure it out. Soon there will be a coordinated lunar time, or basically a time zone for the moon. It's not easy to figure out the time on the moon. Time slows down on satellites because they experience lower gravity and because they're speeding around us at hundreds of miles an hour. That's why a lunar day and a lunar night each last 2 weeks. So what time is it on the moon? It's still unclear. NASA has until 2026 to finalize the coordinated lunar time. Also, another, who cares?
I don't care
what time it is on the Pacific coast.
You're not calling anybody on the moon.
I mean, what do I give a rip for? What does anyone care for?
I don't know.
Unless you're on the moon, you don't care.
Honey, I got to call Bill. What time is it on the moon right now? I don't want to wake him up.
That's your government at work.
Trying to figure out
a time somewhere.
Number five, there was an important newsroom discussion about these cookies that are at most supermarkets. They're kind of cakey with frosting on top.
Oh,
Lots of people really love them. And others, not so much. They actually have a name, Loft House Cookies. Oh. These cookies were created back in 1995 by a couple from Utah, Dave and Deanne Stone.
Oh, nice.
Loft House is actually the maiden name of Dave's mother. They started with $2,000. They would drop off free baskets of the cookies at convenience stores. Dave told the store owners he would come back to take orders or just go away if people didn't like them. Well, they sold the company in 2002, and it's safe to say the couple is worth many millions of dollars.
Oh, the kids love those. They love them.
No, kids have no palate.
But they're always soft.
Yes,
and they don't ever get hard. There's something magical.
Or artificial. Yeah. Number four, here's another thing to be scared of. Oh, come on, the bearded fireworm.
Oh, my.
This creepy crawler lives under the sea. If you're stung by one, you'll feel a burning sensation for several hours. Yeah. Paul, you got stung by one of these a while back.
Yeah, it went on for weeks.
Yeah.
You can feel the sting for weeks. Yeah, there you go. While you're unlikely to encounter one, they are washing up in new places.
Yeah.
Some were recently spotted in Texas.
Yeah.
They're super rare there. Experts recommend bringing isopropyl alcohol or vinegar to the beach.
Oh. Oh,
yeah, just toss another thing in your bag in case you encounter one.
I always travel with vinegar, just in case.
All right, let's talk about the 3-3-3-3 rule.
Yes, finally.
This is a survival guideline that estimates how long humans can live without certain necessities. You can go about 3 minutes without breathing. You can go 3 hours without shelter in extreme temperatures. 3 days without water, and 3 weeks without food.
Huh.
How that interesting is that?
Yeah.
The 3-3-3-3 rule. Knowing this, you can prioritize if you find yourself stranded in freezing temperatures.
Right.
First, focus on shelter, then water, then food.
Uh-huh. Did they say you could hold your breath for 3 minutes?
Was 3 minutes, yeah.
Or, not a
shit.
No.
I think they said you'd be all right not breathing for 3 minutes.
Like you wouldn't die if you, I don't know.
Like someone
you
brought you back.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's probably brain damage after
Look,
3 minutes.
Look, I'm not any of those extreme situations.
Listen, if you need mouth to mouth, you're not making it around here.
Well, that's not very
I'm
nice.
Sure
Larry.
Someone
I'm
would
sure
jump
someone
in to help
step
one of the security
up.
Guards.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, Joey's very anxious to get some action over here. So.
Joey doesn't deserve better, Joey.
Larry, come on.
We had a single young woman sitting down here. He is jumping out of his pants to get her phone number.
She was also 20 years old, Larry.
Yeah.
All right, number two.
My turn. Number two, it's Throwback Tuesday, and here's a great commercial from 1982.
Reality 1982, you
were singing this song, you were junior in college.
They stay in your...
What is this for?
Reunity. Why?
1982.
Oh, that's right. I remember that.
It's still around.
But see, part of the slogan is Reunity on ice. Reunity so nice. Who's drinking? It was embedded in my brain.
Yeah.
I still drink wine with ice.
Yeah, you can get it in a can now.
And the classiest wines are the ones that run commercials. During daytime TV.
Yeah.
That's exactly right.
Number one, we came across this fascinating interview with Lucille Ball from when she was on the Dick Cavett Show talking about how she picked up music and possible spy signals through her dental fillings. It's a bit long, stick with it.
All right.
This particular night was about 1:15, and I was driving alone. I had 35 miles to drive, and it wasn't any fun. It was just a normal night. I wasn't frightened or anything. I was just driving along, and a road that I'd taken many times, and all of a sudden, I heard music, but I mean with a great beat, you know, and I looked down to turn off my radio and it wasn't on. And I turned around and looked to see if there's anyone behind me, and the music was getting louder and louder and louder, and I realized it was in my mouth. And it was beating in my ears. I could hear the tune and everything. I recognized the tune. And then it started to fade out.
Yeah.
What the hell was that? You know, what could it possibly be? And I didn't know what it was. So the next day I mentioned it at the studio to Buster Keaton. And he said, what street were you on? Moore Park? And I said, yes. He said, you went by the radio station. You picked it up. Well, you got any fillings? I said, yes. He said, you picked it up in your teeth. Well, I could hardly wait to go by there again. I was going up another street.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
More.
Almost home. And I was passing four vacant lots that were all raised so they could build the Birmingham Hospital. And as I went by there, I heard, I'm picking it up with my teeth.
You mean?
Yes. And I stopped the car. Then I looked around, in a Morse code, like. And I backed the car up, and it got stronger and stronger, and I kept on backing it up until it really got strong, and my whole jaw was vibrating, like this. And then I got the hell out of there. I went boom like this, because it was very late. Yeah. And I couldn't wait to get back to MGM the next morning and tell the security office, and they found an underground Japanese transmitting
radio station.
Radio station. Honest to God.
Is that a great story?
But then they just found it was one of the gardeners calling.
Wow.
Very bizarre. Mm. But what a fabulous outfit.
They knew how to dress back then.
Really
I gotta get
did.
A feather boa.
You just bring it when you go on the talk shows. Well, that's 9 to 9. That was
Wait a minute. It's 9 to 9.